book reading. You go to any lawyer's office, there are collections of various books, some thin, few pages, say one or two pages containing all sections, and there are many voluminous books. Books with lots of pages. For example, CRPC, IPC, CPC. Do you wonder how to comprehend all the information in a easiest way in a given small time frame? Read on. All law source is the Parliament and President under the Constitution's power. Our elected PM has two functions. First, he is heading the executive as Council of Ministers. Second, as being leader of majority group, he causes create the law. The President and Governor, under advice of Council, can make law in form of the ordinance for a limited time period. X comes into existence after publishing the Gazette. There is distinct hierarchy of law. Acts done by Parliament, rule based on this act created by the executives, government policy resolutions, orders, circulars, etc. Let's understand these books. Legal books are always systematically arranged, well indexed, have reverse bibliography. They are truly corrected for legal and lexicological errors. All law books have a similar characteristic, style, arrangement, is their source is one. Question should come into our mind is where this law is applicable. What will be rules made out of it? Who will execute it? What will be that executing agency's power? What will be implications of this law in creating or restricting any rights, putting any obligations, punishment, methodology, structures for implementing this punishment, and its justice mechanism? Grab a book. First thing to see is the name of the word, law. Say, Indian Evidence Act 1872. One of 1872. From name, we can understand it is about evidence. The number in year denotes its hierarchy in time period. If later law changes, we can know what we are referring to. Open the pages. There are content indexes. There will be preamble, chapters, sections, then chapters, footnotes of any letter on corrections, amendments, etc. At the end of the book, there will be bibliography, the reverse index. There will be annexes, forms, formats, rules made from the acts and other relevant informations. In big book, the chapter is arranged in a very logical way. In a chapter, a relevant section dealing with that subject matter is collected. Book is covering all topics, chapter by chapter. No two sections are similar. There is always some difference. In the starting of book, there is definition. Meaning of the words, terms used in the act is given. It is important that you first read these definitions and understand legal usage in context of this law. Take a glance of book index annexes without making any effort to understanding it. Now put away that book. Do similar with all above mentioned books. Take your time. When ready, do the first reading in 2-3 sittings as verbatim. If you understand, good. If you don't understand, is also good. After this first fast reading, you will know the general characteristic and what is the legal scheme of it. Then reread it little slowly. After this, you will know what section is about and what is their interrelationships, how they play, complement, overlap, differ or are similar with each other, and where they are related to other laws. If you are in any doubt, write down that section, page, word in a plain paper to be dealt with later on in third readings or in future. Now you can do the third reading. As a new lawyer, from court practice point, we are only interested in few sections where punishment, creation, restrictions of right is given, how it is implemented, etc. This practical thing is important for us as it earns money from client. Every lawyer speaks just sections number in their talks, but without reading whole book, we cannot understand or make sense of it. So at least three reading is a must. In legal fraternity, it is said law is always referral. When in doubt, grab the book, have a look, make a habit of asking your friendly and somewhat successful big lawyers. He might have enough knowledge, experience of practical implications of that relevant sections is used in the court system. The Indian Constitution, Indian Independence Act 1947, is mother of all guidance. When there is any trouble, we refer there for light. All laws are related to each other, independent as well as interdependent. In some laws, the definition changes because their intention usage is different. Also read the Constitution of India, as that is binding or restricting our individual freedom. What books we need to see? Well, CRPC, CPC, IPC, Evidence Act are day-to-day usage in the court. Then you should read General Clauses Act, Limitation Act, Specific Relief Act, Contract Act, Registration Act, Stamp Duty Act, as these acts are related to most of our day-to-day transactions, human behaviors, etc. There are few more acts and that's it. Otherwise, the law books are immense. What you should master is the way to understand one book, and you master all the books. Do not get stuck at any point. Sections, words, meanings, just move on. Finish the book in few days, say a week's time. Time is important. Have faith that on one fine day, you will get the understanding of all these legal jargons, and there will be light. Last words, whether you are reading, student, lawyer, judge, client, general public, executives, legal entity, lawmakers, your relevant perspective, looking angle might be different, but the basic methodology is same.